Silicon chips are incredibly small, yet one of the most amazing human achievements. Hundreds of billions of tiny switches that control small amounts of electricity are integrated into fingernail-sized chips. From the micrometer level to the nanometer level, even down to the angstrom level, these chips are pushing the boundaries of physics. EDA and IP are indispensable in designing and laying out billions of transistors. So, how are chips made? It begins with the specification of the end application. This is usually a next-generation product that needs more advanced processing capability. Next, the specific manufacturing or fabrication process and reusable IP cores are selected. Take mobile phone chips as an example. With the popularity of live streaming and video recording, the power of desktop computers has been packed into modern smartphones. Thus, high-resolution video recording become a key requirement. For the end application set of mobile phone chips, chip designers implement this and other required features using a hardware description language, or HDL. Verilog, or VHDL, which can mount to millions of lines of code, like a city street plan, where you need to arrange the location for resources and the overall layout of what's allowed where, as well as the layout of the roads and transportation links. Chip design is similar. IP cores are like approved building plans, which are pre-designed, reusable modules, and multiple of them can be placed in the city for specific functions, like libraries and schools. Plus, you can design your own custom buildings and specify how every building can be connected with roads and transport links. But how can you ensure all of your designs are correct and interconnected correctly? For chip design, this involves millions of lines of code. From conception to manufacturing, a chip design undergoes numerous iterations, using EDA tools to detect and help correct any issues. To make sure the design operates as intended, specialized tools are used to test against the designer's intentions. This process, known as functional verification, is essential to ensure the chip meets its specifications. For example, the providing the correct functionality of a mobile phone processor. With the increasing complexity of modern chips, verification has become one of the most critical steps in chip design. After functional verification, the design process moves to logic synthesis, where the HDL code is broken down into lower-level logic circuits. Before HDLs existed, circuits were hand-drawn, which significantly limited how many could be built on one chip. Today, chips can contain billions of transistors and are getting ever closer to 1 trillion. The pre-HDL method was rendered obsolete decades ago. In 1986, the revolutionary EDA tool called Design Compiler was introduced. This allows designers to describe circuits with code, ushering in a new era in productivity. This milestone greatly increased the abstraction level of chip design, boosting efficiency, and enabling the design of ultra-complex chips with billions of transistors. Chip technology is constantly evolving, and logic synthesis now involves more than just timing, power, and area constraints. It also includes physical layout requirements, just like city zoning. This complexity has increased, driving ongoing innovation and advancements in technologies and tools. As the design progresses, the description of a chip evolves from HDL code to lower-level netlists, and then to lowest-level gate and transistor-level layouts, known as physical design. This involves placing and routing the circuit based on the synthesized netlist to determine the transistor's shapes, areas, and positions on the chip. This process, called physical implementation, which includes the steps such as floor planning, cell placement, clock tree synthesis, and routing. In essence, designers must direct the placement of each logical block and how they interconnect. This design flow is called layout and routing. Different colors in the layout represent various routing layers. A 7-nanometer chip often requires dozens of layers. When designing physical layouts, it's crucial to ensure all circuit elements are correctly connected and meet physical design rules, known as manufacturing process requirements. Additionally, IC designers must continuously optimize and balance metrics, such as timing, power, and area, to find the best solution. The IC design involves a vast design exploration space, far larger than the number of possible moves in a game of Go. Thanks to AI-driven EDA tools, the layered optimization and testing workloads that used to require many experts' months of work can now be completed in as little as 3 days. In the future, we expect to find optimal solutions even faster. Once all requirements are met, the chip design can be considered as completed. Then, the design files will be transferred to a foundry using a standard file format, which is then used to create the actual circuits on the silicon wafers. After manufacturing, packaging, and testing, we can get the chips we can actually use, but the whole process often takes 1 to 2 years. With each technological leap, the ability of mankind to reshape the world grows exponentially. By harnessing advanced EDA and IP technologies, we craft ever more powerful chips, empowering innovators to drive human advancement. The era of pervasive intelligence will continue to be powered by advancements in semiconductor design.